So I missed something before. Mm-hmm. Who's an operator? Go back.
You go back?
Yeah, let's. Max Planck.
Okay, we go back.
Okay. On the 5th of November 2000, the funeral of Emperor Haile Selassie I took place in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. This was 25 years after his death on the 27th of August 1975. This was 25 years, more accurate historically, this was 25 years after the Derg announced that he had died. That's what we should say.
Yeah.
We shouldn't say as historians after his death. That's important. That's impartial. Somebody said he's dead, so we say yeah. But did we know he's dead? That's why you have to write your own history. People write Ethiopia's history, you know, from their point. So many things I've heard in Ethiopia. It's not quite what they were saying. You were here. You didn't see him. You just know the government said, that's it, and everybody said, all right.
Yeah.
That's the history.
Our people know better. Our church know better. But them keep it into secret. Even it's the pillar of the church. Five secrets.
A big man never dies.
This Berenice voice, huh?
Is this the footage from the said the German
yes.
Max Planck Institute footage?
Yes.
To emphasize a bit what the Nazarene said, let the dead bury the dead.
You know, maybe the audience might get boring unless it is really a Christian pay-per-view, inshallah.
This is the funeral lady that I never went to. I was living in Olympia.
His Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I, the 225th sovereign after Menelik I, son of King Solomon and the Queen of Sheba, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, elect of God, the King of Kings of Ethiopia, is officially entombed. Is this also true for the Rastafarians? They worship Emperor Haile Selassie as God and Messiah, and name themselves after his first title and name, Rastafari. How do they consider this?
Greetings in the name of the Most High, Haile Selassie I, Jah!
Rastafari.
Adjanai. Go Senegas.
They have you on camera, but they don't know who this beautiful elder is. So they're asking you to say your name.
My name is Theophilus Edwards.
Theophilus.
Theophilus?
But the Theophilus. Theophilus.
Something like this. Where did Zion come from?
Zion, yeah.
We call it Elder Zion. It's a man of many names.
My name is Sister John Douglas. Known as Church of Mother, Mama John. I came here in 1976. I've been here for over 40 years now. I take 42 years to be exact. Came from Jamaica. True culture of Israel. You know, it's an organization that was founded by the Lord Prophet Captain Ryan Caravan here in 1960 in Jamaica. I have 6 children, all born in Ethiopia. And I have 8 grandchildren, all born in Ethiopia. Which I give that thanks for.
My name is Petros Lee. I was born in Shash. My parents are from Jamaica, as usual. This is my place called Bolt House. Yeah, I'm like the manager, the head chef.
I'm a member of the 12 Tribes of Israel, and we read the Bible a chapter a day.
Yes.
I am Alex Renia, owner of Zion Chenod in Shashamani, 01 Kabale. Donc, I run the lodge since 10 years now. Donc, I'm so happy and proud to be in Ethiopia, to be repatriated in this beautiful country. It was my dream, and the dream become a reality.
Me, I'm an artist, okay? My name is Jaden, you know, and I'm from Cameroon, you know? So my work is to sing about this, you know, about what I see as a, from this continent, you know? And the first continent where everything started.
I listen to things my life, you know?
Yeah.
That's why I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
With my man, and we live every day for him.
Welcome to the Moblissa Mess. This is my home here in Shashamani. My name is Ras Quintaseb Hidani Meret Selassie. I'm originally born in the island of Trinidad. Came home to Ethiopia. It's now 22 years, this coronation. I came in November 96. And I am an artist, singer, musician, composer. That's how I put over the expression of my faith in Ethiopia.
Yes, I am Sister Aijania Christian. I am resident at the Nyabingi Theocracy Center, the Nyabingi Tabernacle Center in Shashamani, Ethiopia. And I'm very happy to be able to share my knowledge of His Imperial Majesty and what he means to me and to I and I of the Rastafari Nation.
He started his journey from St. Thomas, Jamaica in 1964.
Yes.
He traveled to Ethiopia. Probably heard about it, Noel Dyer. That's my father.
Blessed love, give thanks for life and the mighty love giver. I'm Sister Berenice Morizo, coming from France, and I have been here for 4 months, about 4 months, but it's not my first time in Ethiopia.
Yusuke Japon Uchiyama.
Yusuke Uchiyama.
Yusuke Uchiyama.
Okay. But it's Japon, so the outer Japon, Japon.
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 Yeah, I'm Ras Gion. I'm about to be 29 years old. I arrived here like almost 5 years ago. And I live in this Gojo bed for 4 years and a half, cultivating my garden and serving my community.
My name wants to play, I could tell you.
I was, yeah.
I hope you are
blessed. I was sent to Shashamani by 12 Tribes of Israel. Okay. Yeah, 12 Tribes of Israel from Trinidad.
And Tobago.
No, from Trinidad and Tobago. And it's been 1 year. Well, I think the next month will make a year since I'm here. You know? I really love and enjoy Shashamani. I mean, God blessing is here, you know? And you haven't failed me. Since I've been on this journey, you know, so I've given a song that Sister Ajana really liked that. Help me. Just didn't write it too, huh?
ሲዞን ሻሸመኔ ወረዳ ልዩ ስሙ መልካወዳ በተባለ አካባቢ ነው። አሁን ያለንበት ቦታ የቅድስት ኪዳነ ምሕረት ደብረ ጽጌ ቤተክርስቲያን ቅጥር ግቢ ውስጥ ነው። ይህ ቦታ ታሪካዊ ቦታ ነው። እንደሚታወቀው ታሪካዊነቱም በጥንት ከ1928 እስከ 33 እንደ ኢትዮጵያ አቆጣጠር አገራችን በተወረረበት ሰዓት ለሀገራችን የተጋደሉ የሞቱ አባት አርበኞች እዚህ በአጼ ኃይለ ሥላሴ እንዲሰፍሩ ወይም እንዲኖሩ የተደረገና የተሰጣቸው ቦታ መሆኑ አንዱ ታሪካዊ አድርገዋል። በተጨማሪም በሌላ በኩል ከዚህ ማዶ ከወንዙ በስተጀርባ ራስተፈሪያንስ የሚባሉ ከካሪቢያን ማለትም ውጪ የመጡ እነሱም እዚህ ቦታ አጼ ኃይለ ሥላሴ ቀደም እንደገለጽኩት ከበሳቸው አማካኝነት እዚህ ቦታ እንዲያርፉ ወይም ቦታ ተሰጥቷቸው እንዲኖሩ ተደርጓል። ለጃም ረጅም አመት ነው ያው ከዛሬ ኦልሞስት ወደ 40 50ዎቹ አመታት በፊት ነው እዚህ የመጡት በጣም የተወሰኑ ውስን ነበሩ። በአሁን ሰዓት ግን እነሱን እየተከተሉ እነሱን የመሰሉ ከጀርመን ከተለያዩ ሀገሮች ከጣሊያን የመጡም አሉ። ግን የመጀመሪያዎቹ ጃማይካ ናቸው። እነዚህ ሰዎች ጃማይካ ናቸው። ለዚህ ኃይለ ሥላሴ ይሄንን ቦታ ሰጥቷቸው እስካሁን ድረስ እየኖሩበት ነው ያለው። ያ ቦታ የጃማይካ አካባቢ ይባላል ወይም ራስተፈሪያንስ አካባቢ ይባላል። ራስተፈሪ ያው በግልጽ እንደምናቀው ታሪካዊ እንትን ያላቸው ናቸው። እና እንግዲህ እዚህ አካባቢ ታሪካዊ ዳራ ወይም ሁኔታ ይሄን ይመስላል።
So we hold fast to the knowledge of the living eye represented in the person of His Imperial Majesty Haile Selassie I. That is the spirit that gives life to what we think, say, and do, especially here in Shashamani land. Because this is again another instance of foresight. You either stand that at some point these people who are taken away are going to want to come home, some of them at least. It remains, Shashamani land grant remains the only example on the African continent of land granted by an African ruler for the black peoples of the world. You know how significant that is? We wish the others would catch up, would wake up perhaps, and then catch up. And I say that with great love for this continent as my mother.
When I came here by 1976, was already angry. Each of us said, oh, that's the American flag. And they didn't recognize it was the flag of some of the local people. But now I've seen everybody with flattering. And I'm proud because I'm happy because we have been doing this for many years. You know, so we love each other too much.
ここにここのここ全体の国に
来る、あ、来て、
うん、
いや、それはやっぱりハイレセラシエがこの地にで生まれたっていうのもあるし、
うん
うん、あのそうなるべきやってんって、イグザビエルがそうしたんやって、それはもうそうなるべきやってん。
も
うそうなるべきやって。
でザモーネアルバナガノ
ウラスタはここに。
ラスタはジマノ
ウラ。来るはずやし、あるはずや。
ジマンタタルバジマノウ
ラ。でもここにラスタがいてへんかった。意味変わんねん。今からメディカルマリファナの時代なんで。今あっこはアスファルトはチャートの店やけど。あとアムスターメットで。
アスファルト
ganja bicha になんねん。
ganja bicha にな
る。メディカルマリファナが流行ってみんなここでマリファナ売り出す。チャート。ダメ、チャートダメ。このコシャシャマネーじゃないねん。
コシャシャマネーさん。
ジャジャマネーに。
ジャジャマネーよ。
コシャシャマネーじゃないねん。
Man from Angola, Jaja Mane. Oh, South Africa, you got it reading Jaja Mane. Welcome to the valley, Jaja Mane. Big strength to the valley, in Jaja Mane. All Africa, welcome to the gathering.
I like to tease that there are only two kinds of people in the world. Those who know His Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I, as the living eye, and those who don't.
We don't consider ourselves as religious people here.
Mm.
We don't claim to be a religion.
Mm.
It's more way of life.
Mm.
You know, way of living, way of thinking, of behaving, than religion. Because we don't have no pope, we have no bishop, no deacons, not such organization, structure and things, you know. Because Rasta is very recent, very new in this world, you know. Rasta started in the 30s with the coronation of His Majesty in Jamaica. You know?
You will find a lot of point of view and a variety of understanding and interpretation about who the man is. So, but basically, he is the inspiration for all of us, you know? I couldn't have a statement on who Haile Selassie is for the Rastafari, but we have his name, you know, Rastafari, you know, some call us Rasta. As a matter of fact, we as Rastafari or Rastafarian, although I don't really follow that kind of name, you know. Just keep the legacy going on. Yeah.
Actually, I give thanks and praises in the name of His Imperial Majesty, Haile Selassie I, and that alone tells you something of an I relationship with that man. And we also give praises to His Empress Menen, because as you know, Haile Selassie means power of the Trinity. For us, the Trinity is not three male persons, but the Father, the Mother, and the Child, which is the basis of the African family. And we know that we must ensure that the family and the power of the African family is never lost.
So His Majesty was that divine inspiration. He was the eternal guide to I and I, because he was a man who stood up to Mussolini, and it's the same Roman Empire. We fight in Roman Catholicism. So it is that spiritual connection that embody I and I within His Majesty and the fullness as a conqueror.
In Shashamani, in the Nyabingi Tabernacle Center, as is usual with the Nyabingi Order, we observe many holy days associated with the persons of His Imperial Majesty Haile Selassie I and Empress Menen. And we also recognize the holidays in the Ethiopian calendar. Many of them, not all of the church holidays. We've just finished celebrating on November 2nd. We celebrated on the 1st and the 2nd, the coronation, the anniversary of the coronation, the 83rd anniversary of that momentous occasion that took place on November 2nd, 1930. And it is of great significance to Rastafari because His Majesty created new tradition and set a precedent by having His Empress crowned in the church in the same ceremony as himself, and not 3 days later in the palace, as used to be the custom. This is very empowering. His Majesty is saying, you are the Empress. Your role, your place is on that throne beside my own. And we're talking about not just a merciful and compassionate God, but a wise one.
His Imperial Majesty, the King of Ethiopia, my view towards is that the way our parents teach us and told us and taught us is that He's the King of Kings, you know? From Christ, He came in that character of Christ, so it's not that we worship Haile Selassie as a God, but we know that He's the King. When we read the Bible tells us, you know, Israel is never short of a prophet, neither a king. So that's why we love Haile Selassie as a king, because he came to Jamaica. He's the one who brought us here to Ethiopia. If it wasn't for the king, his majesty, we'd still be in bondage, we black people.
As a person who comes from a Rastafari family, as well as a community, you know, it's very impossible. And knowing the impact that Haile Selassie is to my father, you know, and I am a father offspring, so I have the same energy, it still flows, you know. So I don't accept. You know, people may say, oh, it's the 21st century, how could you say this man don't die, he's just a king, nah, nah, nah. But just like Sister Ijania has said earlier, there are two people in the world, one that knows Haile Selassie and the other that doesn't know.
The picture that you get, Haile Selassie is a great man, but even him, he says that, you know, he believes in God, that he follows Jesus Christ, and he knows that Jesus Christ is our Savior. So if we believe in Haile Selassie and the things that he says, we need to listen to what he says. And he's telling us we can be good, Christ-like. That's what we strive to be. We all want to be like Christ. And His Majesty came very close. But He's not Christ, and He's not God.
But Rasta is Rasta. You know, I'm a Rasta disciple. I'm a Rasta follower. You know? Haile Selassie is my king. Mm-hmm. You know, he's my Messiah. At the Breaking Chain, he's our Christ. Black Christ, by the way. You know, so proud as a black man to have a black Christ, man. You know? I don't believe in a white Jesus. No. At all.
Haile Selassie is God. He's the creator of Rastafari. He's the creator of everything. The shoes you have, the pan you have, the clothes you have, the everything you have, Haile Selassie created it. Everything for man. Haile Selassie is Ababa Janoi. He's the Ababa Janoi. That is good. That is my family, but Rastafari the first. King Rastafari.
Looking for who you turn off the light. No husband's attention left.
You see, this is a difficult question for me to answer because it is a question based on the presumption that he's gone and is therefore only to be remembered. I am not in the business of remembering. I am in the business of living and learning from the example set by His Majesty so that he will never go. He will never actually ever, ever leave us.
And I remember when I was just a little kid, like growing up back in the town, like, I could vividly remember that they said Haile Selassie was dead, and it was on the news. It was in almost when the dirt was getting out, I guess. And my father was so, like, you know, so vexed, like he was in his wrath, like, you know, Haile Selassie didn't die. Like, how could they say that?
Yeah, we don't consider this death thing is a different meditation of man. We come to live as man. Selassie, I guess we live to eternity. Tomorrow is a star in the sky. But this death thing, no, that is not. That is what you see they try to embed in your head. Yeah, so you will not respect creation. Creation have no death. Creation is ever living. Yeah.
Just a talk from a government who, as my brother who wrote the book Agony in the Palace said, when he heard of it, as an Ethiopian in prison at the time under the dirk, he heard in the dirk time, you know, that they discovered in a mass grave a skull that resembled Haile Selassie's, and that therefore they told the people. And he, as an Ethiopian, Said, a pack of lies. They just tell lies when you can't believe nothing. They got these old bones, which the Derg had said they had found. So it's all, it turns out it's all rumor. The Derg says we've got some bones. To me, logically, if the Derg who would want to change the whole culture, religion, social and political setup of Ethiopia, you want to come off 3,000 years of history or more, you're going to say, this man, king, who we revere as our father or divinely sent, Seyoum Xavier Medani Allen, is in the religion. So king is in the religion of Ethiopia. To change from king, you have to change the religion. Because the Orthodox Church tells us that the conquering line of the tribe of Judah must sit on the throne one day as the Christ himself. The Bible tells us that. So the Orthodox Church of Ethiopia organized their church and their history for thousands of years to try to fulfill that prophecy. By doing what? Keeping the bloodline of David and Solomon. Because that's the criteria. Written in the scriptures, the Holy Scriptures. So Ethiopia is the only place that has that. So to deny all that, you would at least have to bring out the head of the man who you just cut off and you're replacing him and show to the nations and the world that he is now no longer a living, roaring lion. He is now a dead dog. He's not, we have killed him. He doesn't exist anymore. He can't be all that divine manam now. Just like they killed Christ. They did it publicly. And they humiliate him and put him and to show he can't be such a great God after all. Look what we can do to him. And it was suspicious to the world councils, to the world governments, because I think even Germany is one of the people who sent, they sent a team of experts here, osteoporopists, or how you call the bone experts. They said when these bones were discovered, a few nations said, if this is really Janhoi, this kind of man, you know, we have to know, to show that it's really him, to honor that he's done it. So I heard that before coming to living children. Coming to check this bone structure that they were claiming was Janhoi, they didn't even have to go as far as DNA tests or anything like that. Because in measuring simply this bone here, this tibia, it's called from the knee to the ankle, they found it was a man that was way taller than the height that Janhoi is known to have.
I just see it as a big mess and, you know, a big, just a big joke, you know? Me, I think that if you don't have a body, you don't have a dead person, you know?
But as an Ethiopian, if I, as an Ethiopian, looking at that matter, the doctor, whose name had signed the death certificate, according to the government at that time, the Derg, afterward denied that he was anywhere near there. Said no, that he never signed any death certificate.
A big man never dies.
Well, this is what I'm saying to you. We know the stories because we always follow anything to do with His Majesty. We know that several sets of bones were found. We know that one set were too short and the other set were too long. We know those stories. And then a set was eventually buried. And I believe the intention was to bury His Majesty. But you're talking to Rastafari as a living eye. His Imperial Majesty, Haile Selassie I, and Her Majesty Empress Menen, they not only live, but they reign within I and I hearts.
These things are very much a living history. Is the best example I've got of it is from a Batawi who came here in Shashamani and told a group of school students who were asking him about Rastafari. He said, you all don't know anything about the emperor. You know, he said, Janhoi is living right now in Lalibela. Go to Lalibela, see if they are, because this is what I'm hearing now, that the youths rising up in Lalibela with their dreads will tell you of the man who comes there every year or 2 years to certain feasts and festivals and appears to them. Pictures are appearing on the internet of this man. So we have to check out those things, you know.
The man from India. I don't remember his name.
I too, it's literally
His Majesty in 1981. In England.
The procession. The
yeah, you know, big ahead. Ceremony. Yeah. He sees His Majesty there. The and after he say, people, he meet His Majesty. His Majesty said to him,
I was want to build the how you say that?
Emperor Haile Selassie the First. His name
the Kingdom of God in the earth.
Ruled as emperor for 44 years.
And he said, divine mind never die. Rasta is not color. The color of Rasta is unity, this color.
So from the beginning, from birth, it is, he's been testified of. And now they say he's dead and blah, blah. They can't prove one peep. Mm. One peep. As you said, it's for the family. Mm. It's for the Ethiopian culture that we've cried for him. We've done things and just... Mm. But to take it to the next level, you know, that the level that we say we have the faith, we read it in our Bible, we believe that Christ, take it to even think in those levels. You gotta, we, it's Rasta who's pushing that. Only Rasta too. Only Rasta. We have to keep our zeal, we have to keep some level of integrity that we can represent these ideas. You know, to, first of all, to Ethiopian, to African in general, to world.
So when we talk about peace and love and justice, and these things are reflected in the teachings of His Majesty that we know through His speeches and so on, that we study as a third testament, so to speak. So this is who His Imperial Majesty is. Remarkable as a man, even without that spiritual interpretation, Haile Selassie commanded a world stage and still manages to do so. That is why you're in Shashamani talking to me right now.
Eines schätze ich an Sie besonders. Und das ist die Tatsache, dass die Rastas leider Gottes inzwischen einer der wenigen Institutionen sind, die noch einen panafrikanischen Glauben haben. Wissen Sie, das ist ja fast vergessen. In Afrika sehe ich das nicht mehr. Wenn ich da an meine eigene Schulzeit denke, ich möchte Ihnen sagen, 1963 wurde die Organisation der Afrikanischen Einheit in Addis Abeba gegründet und es gab ein Spiel auf der deutschen Schule. Man ging auf einen äthiopischen Schüler hin und sagte, woher kommst du? Natürlich, wohlwissend, woher? Sagte, ich bin Äthiopier. Ja. Kriegte eins auf drei. Falsche Antwort. Was wäre die richtige Antwort gewesen? Ich bin Afrikaner.
Haile Selassie, he worked to make this continent together, you know, Africa together, you know, and that's the best thing he do, because he creates some place where African people can meet and talk together, and you know, see the solution to make ourselves to unite, you know, and Haile Selassie do that, you know, no one do before him. No one do after him.
Mm-hmm. We not come to fight no tribal war. We don't understand this tribal domination. That is one thing with the colonial experience. They took all of us of different tribes and nations and put us on one slave ship. So you see, when you reach where we reach here, you won't study whether you're from the Congo, you're from the Ethiopia, or you Oromo. All of us had to become one people. So most of us who come from the Caribbean, that is the only experience, you know, with one people, one heart, one harmony.
I'm going to go to the house. የተቋቋመላቸው ያንን መሰረት ባደረገ መልኩ ነው።
ልዑል በእደ ማርያም መኮንን አጥር ያለ ንግግር ያደርጋሉ።
ከጎናችን ያልተለያችሁ ኢትዮጵያውያን ሁሉ ዋና የማይለየው የኢትዮጵያ ሕዝብ አምላክ እንዲከፍላችሁ እንመኛለን።
አቡነ ጳውሎስ ደስ ሙስማን ዛሃግን ኢምሃብ ዘር ፊት ጽፈታ Er hat mit dem Ganzen eine Aura gegeben, die einfach nicht möglich wäre, wenn die Kirche nicht mit vollem Pomp da gewesen wäre. Dass diese Jugend zum ersten Mal sehen konnte, was die äthiopische Flagge bedeutet. In einer Zeit, wo das Staatsoberhaupt, das war genau um diese Zeit, um 2000, offiziell verkündet hat, was ist schon eine Flagge, es ist nur ein Stück, ein Stoff und nichts weiter. Und wie Sie gesehen haben, dass der Sarg in den äthiopischen Farben bekleidet war, dass die äthiopische, alte äthiopische Fahne mit dem Löwen überall wehte. All das hat eine Art Patriotismus wieder erweckt, was wir brauchen. Wir brauchen in Äthiopien das unter dem Motto Einheit in Verschiedenheit und Verschiedenheit in Einheit.
Mit was denn? An den Jahren hast du am Lack nach Joba in Nacho. Sie haben nach Joba in Nacho. በዚህ እምነታቸውና በዚህ ግንዛቤ አስተሳሰባቸው ላይ ደግሞ በዚያን ጊዜ ልክ የእነሱን እንትን ትራንጎ ይህንን የቀብር ስነ ስርዓት ዋጋ ለማሳጣት ጎን ለጎን የሚናፈሱ እንትኖች ነበሩ። አንደኛ አጽማቸው ጋሎን ላይ ተገኘ፣ እዛ ጋር ተገኘ እንጂ ሁለተኛ ሳይመረመር ያልሆነ እንትን ወስደው እንዲህ አደረጉ። የእኛ ደግሞ በሕይወት ዘመናቸው በነበሩበት ወቅት የነበራቸውን ገጽታ ከጥርሳቸው፣ ከአፍንጫቸው፣ ከሙሉ እንትናቸው፣ ሌላው ደግሞ አልባሳታቸው አብሮ የተገኘውን እንደዚሁም ደግሞ ዋናው እሳቸው ህይወታቸው ካለፈ በኋላ ቀብሩ የተፈጸመበትን ቦታ ቀብሩን የፈጸመውና ያስፈጸመው ክፍል በአካል ተገኝቶ እዚህ ነው ብሎ በማሳየቱ እዛ ላይ ቁፋሮ ሲደረግ ያው ትክክለኛ ከዚህ ይህንን እንደገና ወስደህ ሌላ
ይህንን ቀብር ያዘጋጀው ኒውሮን ፋውንዴሽን ናቸው። ኤግዛይል ላይ ያለው እንትን ፋሚሊ እና ቸርች ነው። እንዲሁም ደግሞ ራስተፈሪያንስ ይላል። ከየት ግን ራስተፈሪያንስ ከቆቆም ፖስትሬም ነው? ማን ነው ይህን ፓወንቱና ቀብሩን እንዲቀብሩ ያደረጋቸው ማን ነው? ሁለተኛው ደግሞ ሁልጊዜ ሂስትሪ እና እምነት የተለያዩ ነገር ኢየሱስ እኛ ተነስቷል ብለን እናውቃለን። አልሞተም ብለው ይሁዳዎች ገና አልመጣም ብለው ያምናሉ። ሙስሊሞች ነብይ ነው እንጂ ኮንትሮቨርሻል ነው። ሁልጊዜ እምነትና ታሪክ የተለያየ ነገር ነው። ስለዚህ እነሱ በሚያምኑበት መንገድ ይሄዳሉ። የታሪኩ ሀቅ ግን ይሄ ነው ነው እና ትንሽ ሁልጊዜ ኮንትሮቨርሻል ከመሆን አይድንም። ይህማ ዓለም እንዲሆን ነበር ኮንትሮቨርሲ ባይኖር። ስለዚህ በሃይማኖት እና በታሪክ መካከል ሁልጊዜ ውዝግብ ስለሚኖር እነሱ በሃይማኖት በኩል እምነት ነው። እምነት ደግሞ ራስን አሳልፎ ያጣ ነገር ነው። እኛ ደግሞ የታሪካቸውና በታሪክ ላይ የተመሰረተ እና በተገኙ እምነት ላይ የተመሰረተ ነው። ስለዚህ ማስታረቅ አዳጋች ነው በጣም።
አልዞ ሲባንዳ ሳትሚሽ ገቡንደት ባህላ ሊበ ደን ሲፈናይነን ያ die Tatsache, dass er tot ist. Mhm. Und wenn sie sie gefragt hätten, hätten sie gesagt, ja, weil sein Name wieder genannt wird, mhm, weil hier an ihn gedacht wird, deshalb sind wir gekommen. Aber keiner würde ihnen sagen, die sind zum Begräbnis des Kaisers gekommen.
Everyone was there, mm-hmm, and so everyone was seeing and respecting over the world. So why this kind of coronation? It's only Ethiopian people, you know. You don't see like people, the world, like, okay, it's very true, you know. So when I see that and the time they make this, it was like what they say, long time. So if they take it long time, why they know they don't do it like on that time? Why they do it now, 2000? No, man, doesn't make sense. That's no African culture. If you bury someone, it's the time. It's not like you're going to wait
for 20 years.
No, this is Africa. It's the same, the same. So this is just, okay, they want to close something.
Yeah, they want to make a symbolic.
So let's close this, you know, and people are going to see.
It's sad, it's very sad, because they have a lot of people around, and everybody thinks His Majesty was inside, you know?
Sacrifice.
Yeah. Mm. Donc, it's very sad because it was there, his people, you know? And they don't believe at us, you know? Like us. Mm. So the only things I seen, and I was happy to see that, to see all the elders very sad, you know? And with
tears,
you know, mm, because they liked him, you know, mm, they know him, mm, they knew him very well, that's why. But it's sad to see they follow the rest of the people.
Donc, for me, this funeral looks like very, very funny. And even... For me, my deep opinion, it's a disaster. I see the Ethiopian Orthodox Church Tower go participating in that. Make me sad, really. Mm-hmm. Make me sad. Because they're supposed to support, you know, faith, hope, you know, and charity.
In general, the Rasta people who in Ethiopia, in other words, in general, Rasta didn't go to that burial. One or two individuals did, that I know. But what I want to, I would love if someone who, like yourself, who's, you know, put in your mind to this point, mm-hmm, would investigate, because I've heard reports from a few people who were there, that the moment came when there was an embarrassment at, mm-hmm, that burial. Yes. Because when they put the coffin with the supposed bones of the deceased emperor, yeah, into the slot into which it is supposed to, you know, the mausoleum type, or anything, mm-hmm, but, yeah, mm-hmm, that the coffin couldn't fit. Mm-hmm. You know about this, mm-hmm, right? So it couldn't fit in. Mm-hmm. And they had to put up a big screen. So I say it was like an embarrassment. Mm. They had to put up a screen so people couldn't see while they dug it out, mm, to make the coffin fit. Mm. So that fits in with the premise that the coffin was too long and that the bones were not the bones of the king, which is perfectly measured to fit into that thing from a long time ago. You know, Ethiopians are expert in stone. There's no mistake about the length of the coffin and fitting it there. That's an impossible mistake. The family of His Majesty are very happy that the Rasta movement kept alive and never moved from promoting and reminding of the glory of His Majesty as an individual and as a ruler and as a great man in world affairs in this time. And moreover, as a Messiah, as the Messiah. So they will take the political, they want to take the glory, but they don't want to acknowledge Him in that spiritual light. I'm speaking of the family now. to the extent that I do. So that's where the difference goes. So they are the ones, this is now the information I got living here in Ethiopia, who really pushed for that burial. Because exactly as you say, it's a shame, like, if a man doesn't have a burial officially. And for Rasta, I and I were more riding on that. The coronation, there's a coronation, but there's no burial. That's one of the Rasta talk. There's no burial of the king.
Oh, it is a family. Yeah. I can fully agree with that, you know. Them, the one who even today are still bringing more evidence that Haile Selassie is dead. Even them have buried him, they still have to find new ways, new document, investigate, spend a lot of money to get in some what you call archives, even to produce forgery. Unbelievable, you know, if I tell you little knowledge I have about this. I love every human being, so for me they're not different than other human beings, but for sure, for them is the main issue to bury Ababa Janhoi, you know, because they have pretension to go in the throne. To go in the throne, there is still a crown council up to today. And us, we believe in revolution. We are revolutionaries. Them are reactionaries, you know. So them just wait a political climate to come after we are the throne of David, and just to wait the church who have brainwashed between politics and religion, and then them come, we are the bridge between, we are Abiy Ahmed and Abu Napolo. Some disgusting thing I don't want to see. That's why I'm sure them really agree anytime some international conference about the burial, about death of His Majesty, you know, them even promote it.
Document. This is oral document. A generation last year, if you look at the government, and the government, about to change, lagaracho, yalemenum kafiya. Honestly, lagar fikar simbi, and the sastwa chu, yalemenum demos kafiya. Damacho, atentacho, kaskaso, chinagar lenya kozito. Ahone minnagin atentagar. Zen in the soal for. He to the dagmo, minimumquan yet or net tarik sound, merraka velabet. Dagnagar tarikawi, homunaguchi, masavasa, limatun. በጎ በጎ ነገሮችን በመስራት የነሱን ታሪክ ማስቀጠል መቻል አለበት። እና አንዱ ነገር ታሪክ ራሱ መጻፍ ታሪክን ለቀጣይ ለአፍሪካ ከዛም ለዓለም እንዲታወቅ ማድረግ ምክንያቱም ትውልድ ቀጣይ ነውና ያን የማድረግ ኃላፊነት ተጠበቀበታልና ያባቶቻችንን ፈለግ ተከትለን እቺን ሀገር ጠብቀን በልማት በመልካም አስተዳደር በቀጣይ በጥሩ ሁኔታ ማስተላለፍ ይጠበቅብናል የሚጠበቅበታል የሚል መልእክት ማስተላለፈው ለዚህ ትውልድ
What we learn from His Majesty is nothing is impossible. You see? Yeah, all challenges we can just defeat them and you know do something with all challenges because I don't know what I would have done if I was the king of Ethiopia at that time, you know, seeing the amount of things that you had to deal with. You know, so full respect and honor and glory, you know, to the king of kings, Selassie Jah, Rastafari, yes.
Yeah. Rastafari, the gathering in Shashamani, all Africa, the gathering in Shashamani, from the top. We're coming from the east, we're coming from the west, yeah. We're coming from the north and south, the
gathering in Shashamani, gathering in Shashamani,
the gathering.
The gathering in Shashamani,
the gathering in Shashamani. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Shine some light to Jah, make it right. Teach us thy way. Don't care what no one says.
And we burn a cappello
in Shasha
Ma.
Yeah, Rastafa.
believing, ever faithful.